In continuation of the first part of this lecture, here we will discuss some indirect methods for the determination of the consumptive use or evapotranspiration. In first part, we have discussed the direct method, the experimental methods, which were the tank and dosimeter method, the field experimental plots, soil moisture studies, integration method, inflow and outflow studies for large areas. Okay. So now here we will discuss the indirect methods, or we can say that the empirical methods, yeah, the methods which were derived by the different researchers based on the experiments. Again, these methods are again based on the direct methods. So there are various methods are available to estimate the evapotranspiration values of different crops. See, as we have already discussed, so we are not going in too much detail again to that that types, like the consumptive use or the evapotranspiration is different for different crops in different areas, and also that is depend on the cropping period, it is also depend on the stage of the growth, it is also depend on the climatic conditions, okay, the soil condition. So different methods are also available, different equations are also available, but the most simple and commonly used methods are the Blaney-Criddle equation, the Pinman equation, and the Hargreaves method. Okay, so these three are the most widely used methods both for the irrigation requirement, irrigation purposes, okay, to design the different structures, irrigation structures. So that will be based on the consumptive use. So that consumptive use, that evapotranspiration can also be determined by utilizing these equations. So first we have already discussed the direct method, which were the experimental method, the practical method. Now here, if the sufficient data is available, the climatological data or the meteorological data is available, then we can utilize these equations to determine the consumptive use of a specific area more quickly. Okay. So the first method is the Blaney-Criddle equation. So relatively, this is a simplistic method for the calculating of the evapotranspiration. So see, because here just three parameters or three terms are utilized in this equation. Okay, so that is the equation which giving us the consumptive use by a specific crop in centimeter per month. Okay, I mean this equation is used to determine the monthly consumptive use of a specific crop at a given area in the given climatic conditions. Okay. CU is the monthly consumptive use, remember that is in centimeter. Okay, here you can see that T, that is the mean monthly temperature. Okay, as we have discussed that the Blaney-Criddle equation is used to determine the monthly consumptive use of a specific crop. Okay, so suppose if you are interested to determine the monthly consumptive use of a crop for the month of May, okay, so what is the mean monthly temperature of that month? Okay, so T is that one. Similarly, P is the monthly percent of annual daylight hours, okay, that occurring in that specific period, okay, that in that specific month in which you are interested to determine the consumptive use. So as we know that generally or averagely we have 2, 4, 3, 9 hours sunlight hours in 1 year. Okay, I mean that is the annual sunlight hours, mean 2, 4, 3, 9. Okay, if suppose we are interested to determine the consumptive use for the month of May, so see, we have to measure or we have to observe that what is the actual sunlight hour, yeah, what is the sunlight hours in the month of May, then that monthly sunlight hours divided by annual sunlight hours multiplied by 100, you will get that P, that is the monthly percent of annual daylight hour. Okay, so daylight hour, monthly percent of daylight hour. And see the K is the crop factor. Now again, as we have already discussed that the consumptive use is different for the different crops at different area, so this K is that crop factor that will be variable, that will be different for different crop, and again that is determined experimentally. Okay, I mean different experiments are already performed by different researchers to determine the K values. Okay, so already some values of the K for the standard crops are already available, like rice, wheat, maize, sugarcane, and so on. Okay, these are the average values for that crop factor, but we can utilize the average value, we can use the average value. Okay, but betterly first we have to experimentally determine the value of crop factor for the given area for a specific crop at a given area. But if it is not given, so we can utilize these average values. We can utilize these values, okay, for the given area. And also, as we have discussed, that the monthly daylight hour, or the monthly percentage of sunshine hours, that is P. So again, that will be depend on the locality of the area. That will be depend on the position. Okay, that where you are. For example, if you are, for example, at 40 degree latitude to the north, and you are interested to determine the monthly daylight hour for the month of May, so then you can take it 10.02. Okay, so almost you either you can calculate it, or you can determine it, or you can take it from this already tabulated values. Okay. So just we have that is just a simplistic equation. Only the mean monthly temperature will be required, okay, and the monthly percent of sunshine hours will be required, okay, and the K values can be calculated or determined, or it will be already taken from the or it will be taken from already determined values, okay, from the tabulated values, okay. So just we have only three parameters are involved. So you will get the monthly consumptive use of a specific crop in the in centimeter. Okay, now we have just a simple examples from which it will be more clear. See, using the Blaney-Criddle equation or the Blaney-Criddle formula, estimate the yearly consumptive use of water for the sugarcane. Okay, so see, as we already know that sugarcane is a perennial crop, mean it require the irrigation throughout the year. Okay, so see, okay, one thing more before the explanation of this problem. See, the general equation for the consumptive use of the Blaney-Criddle equation is equal to Kp, okay, divided by we can say that 40 into 1.8 T, okay, plus 32, okay, that is the general equation. See, here the temperature will be in degree C, P will be in percentages, and K is the crop factor. Okay, so this will give you the consumptive use for the specific month, only per 1 month. Now, if you are interested to determine the consumptive use for the whole season, okay, so then we have two cases. One case, suppose the K value is constant throughout the season. Okay, if K is constant, means suppose for every month, suppose the K value is constant, but remember, in reality, in actuality, the K value will be variable. Okay, but suppose if only one crop coefficient is given for the whole period, then we can say that only this term will be variable per different month, because per different month we will have different temperature and we will have different P value. Okay, so then the consumptive use for the whole season will be equal to K multiplied by sum of this factor. Mean you have to determine individually for each and every month, you have to determine this factor, then you have to sum of that factor. Suppose if a crop have 4 month season, so determine this factor for the 4 month individually, then sum it and multiply it with the crop coefficient if it is constant throughout the season. Okay, and suppose if it is not constant, for example the K value is also different for the different months, okay, then the consumptive use for the whole season will be equal to the summation of the consumptive use for the individual month. Mean for individual month you have to determine the consumptive use and then you have to sum it. Okay, this factor will be, this term will be considered as F. Okay, and F will be a function of daytime percentage of hours, sunshine hour, and the mean monthly temperature. Okay, so just make the clearance between these two terms. Okay, so see, here you can see that in the given problem, the monthly temperature is given. See, the K crop coefficient is different, that is variable for the different month. Similarly, for the monthly percent sunshine hours is given. Okay, so we can use this equation. Okay, that for each and every month, first we have to determine the consumptive use. Okay, so see, determine the consumptive use per January, then per February, then per March, and then you have to sum of all these values. Okay, so when you sum of all these values, so you will get the we can say the seasonal consumptive use or the annual consumptive use, because sugarcane is a perennial crop. Okay, mean it is available in the field throughout the year. Okay, so that is just a simple equation that for each and every month you can calculate the consumptive use and then sum up the consumptive use of the 12 months. So you will get the yearly consumptive use or water demand or the yearly water utilized by the sugarcane in the given area at a given climatic condition. Okay, now secondly, we have the Penman method. So remember, when sufficient meteorological data is available, then this method will be preferred. Okay, because it is more accurate. Yeah, I mean more meteorological parameters are involved in it, so its accuracy or its we can say that its accuracy is more than as compared to the Blaney-Criddle method. But remember, it required a lot of meteorological data. Okay, so see, first remember that this equation was developed by the Penman, and its principle was based on the energy budget and the mass transfers approach. Remember, these two are the basic principle which are involved in the evaporation and transpiration. See, as we have discussed that the 99% of water utilized by the crops are in term of the evaporation and transpiration. Okay, and remember, the evaporation and transpiration are governed by the solar energy. Okay, so that will be depend on the sunshine hour, the intensity of the sunshine. Okay, mean the intensity of the solar radiation. Okay, so actually that solar radiation is converting the water from liquid form into the vapor state. Okay, and remember that we can utilize that equation that the energy principles will be utilized, the energy budget will be utilized, that the total energy will be constant. Just it will only convert the state of the matter. It will only convert the state of the water from the liquid state into the vapor state. Okay, so just that principles are utilized in the development of this, we can say that in this formula. Okay, so see, we will discuss one by one the parameter of the Penman equation. So here, that is the evapotranspiration. Okay, that is represented in term of millimeter per day. Okay, mean Penman equation is used to determine the consumptive use or the evapotranspiration of a specific crop in 24 hour. Okay, millimeter per day. Okay, now see here, this alpha, that is the psychrometric constant. Okay, again, already we have discussed that the evaporation and transpiration is a function of the solar energy, and that is a function of the we can say that the sunshine hour. Okay, so the vapor pressures are involved in the conversion of the water. Okay, that suppose more water will be converted if there is more deficiency between the saturated vapor pressure and the actual vapor pressure. Okay, so this is a little bit that parameter related to these that terminologies, so we are not going in too much detail, but it is just a constant here. Okay, you can just remember its value. Okay, memorize its value, 0.49 millimeter mercury, we can say that per degree C, that is its unit. Okay, so it is a psychrometric constant. Clear? The second one, the A. Clear? A is the see, if you are interested to determine the consumptive use for a specific area, so it will have some specific temperature. Okay, now what is the temperature of that locality? You have to practically observe it. Clear? Second one, what will be the saturated vapor pressure at that temperature? So these are the recommended values, or these are the standard values which we can obtain from the already tabulated data. Okay, the temperature will be practically observed, then we can find out, yeah, we can calculate, yeah, we can take out from the standard tables that what will be the saturated vapor pressure at this temperature. Clear? Now when you plot the temperature with the saturated vapor pressure, so what will be the slope of this plot? That is called A. Okay, mean the A which is given in this equation, that is the slope of the plot between the temperature and the saturated vapor pressure. Clear? Here you can also see in the table that if these temperatures are given, these are the temperatures. Okay, these are the saturated vapor pressures. Clear? If the temperature is plotted with the saturated vapor pressure, then for example at this point, what will be the slope of the plot? So that will be the slope of the plot. Okay, yeah, mean see what will be the slope at this point, so that will be the slope. Okay, so that is the term A which is given in the Penman equation. Clear? Alpha is clear, alpha is A is also clear. Now EA, that is the drying power of the air. Clear? That how much the air is capable to take the moisture content from the crops, yeah, to take the moisture content from the surrounding, okay, into the air. So what will be its drawing power? Okay, so that will be, again, the drawing power of the air is a function of the wind velocity, and it is a function of the difference between the saturated vapor pressure and the actual vapor pressure. See, U2, that is the speed, that is the velocity of the air at 2 meter height from the ground. Okay, mean the speed of the air or the velocity of the air at 2 meter height from the ground, that is U2. Clear? ES, that is the saturated vapor pressure, again, which will be standardized from the given temperature. Okay, and EA, remember, again, you will have to measure the relative humidity of the given area. That what is the relative humidity of the given area. So if you know the relative humidity, clear, and you have the saturated vapor pressure, then the multiplication of the relative humidity with the saturated vapor pressure is called the actual vapor pressure. Clear? So the actual vapor pressure will be calculated, saturated vapor pressure is given, U2 you will have to observe its value, you will have to measure the speed of the air at 2 meter height from the ground, so you will get the drying power of the air. Okay, so EA is also clear. Now next one is the H. See, H is the daily net radiation. Okay, yeah, that is the daily solar radiation. Remember, daily solar radiation. Clear? That will be determined, that will be calculated by using this equation. Clear? So here the RA, that is the monthly solar radiation. Okay, mean monthly solar radiation, sometime we can say that monthly solar radiation is already tabulated, that is already standardized. Okay, the recommended values of the monthly solar radiation for a specific area is already given. Here you can see that in this table. Okay, that will be, again, that will be a function of the latitudes, either you are at the southern hemisphere or you are at the northern hemisphere. Okay, and for which month you are interested to determine the consumptive use, or at what day of the month you are interested. Okay, for example, if you are at 40 degree of the latitude towards the north and you are interested in the month of May, so that will be the mean monthly solar radiation for the month of May at 40 degree of the latitude. Okay, so the monthly solar radiation can be taken out from the table. Clear? R is the we can say that is the reflection coefficient. Okay, that is called the reflection coefficient of a specific crop, that how much light or how much rays can be reflected from the given crop. So see, just remember its range or its average value. So it is varying from 0.15 to 0.25. Okay, that is the that is the variation, yeah, that is the range for the R value. But almost for the crops like rice, wheat, maize, we can take its average value is 2. Okay, see, as much as the crops is dense or closed, then the reflection will be more. Okay, so that is the reflection, the crop reflection. See here, pi, that is the latitude of the area. Okay, the area in which you are interested to determine the consumptive use, so that is the latitude. Okay, come here, and that is the maximum possible sunshine hour. Okay, that for how much hour the sun light will be available. Again, that is a function of the locality, that is a function of the latitude. Here you can see that. Okay, that for example, if you are at 10 degree to the north, so at month of May, what will be the maximum possible sunshine hour? So that is 12.4. Okay, so again, the standard or recommended values are available. Clear? Now the small n, that is the actual sunshine hour in the given area. See, this value will be measured, this value will be observed for the given area. Clear? See, that is already given. Suppose if you are at 10 degree to the north, so what is the maximum possible sunshine hour in that area? That is 12.4 hours. Clear? Now, for example, after noon, for example, if the cloud comes for the for example for the 4 hours. Okay, so then the actual sunshine hour will be 8.4. okay, so that is the actual sunshine hour, and that is the maximum possible sunshine hour. Clear? Okay, here sigma, that is the Stefan-Boltzmann constant. Again, its value is already given, the standard value 2.01. into 10 power minus 9. That is the standard or the constant value for the Stefan-Boltzmann constant, because again here the intensity of the sunrise is involved. So the radiation reflection or the energy transformation that is depend on the solar radiation, so that is just that will be also counted as a function for the drying of the we can say that for the evaporation of the moisture content. Clear? TA, that is the actual temperature of the given area, but remember in this equation it will be in Kelvin. Okay, suppose if actual temperature is for example 15 degrees C, okay, so just add 273 into 8, so that will be converted into Kelvin. So that is the actual temperature in Kelvin. Clear? EA, that is the actual vapor pressure. Clear? N, that is the actual sunshine hour, and capital N, that is the maximum possible sunshine hour. Clear? So just if you have the we can say that the this we can say that if you have the speed of the air at 2 meter height, okay, you have the temperature of the area, you have the relative humidity, and you know the latitude of the area, okay, and you know the actual sunshine hour, then you can calculate the evapotranspiration in millimeter in 24 hours. Clear? For example, see, sometime the speed of the light is measured not exactly at 2 meter. Okay, means sometime the measuring instrument are installed at the top of the at the roof of the we can say that of the buildings. Okay, so see, suppose it is measured at this much height. Okay, suppose that is not 2 meter. Suppose that is Z meter, that is different than 2 meter. Suppose at this much meter, the speed of the velocity is U. Okay, so then what will be the speed of the air at 2 meter height? So then you can also convert it. Remember, if exactly the speed of the air is not given at 2 meter height, if it is given a different height, then you can convert it by utilizing this equation. Okay, so again, remember, if you have the temperature of the area, okay, you have the suppose the relative humidity of the area. Okay, suppose you have the wind speed at 2 meter height, or at any height you can convert it, and if you have the actual sunshine hour, okay, and if you have the we can say that the latitude of the area. Clear? So then you can calculate the crop water requirement. So this these data will be required. Okay, and also one thing more, if N is not observed, mean if the actual sunshine hour is not observed, for example, for the given area, if it is not given, then remember this will be taken as an equivalent to the P. Okay, mean the P which we have discussed in the Blaney-Criddle equation. Okay, if N, the actual sunshine hour for the given area, is not observed, then it will be taken as an equivalent of the P. Okay, for the given area, just remember this point. Clear? Okay, so now we will have just a short numerical on the Penman method, so I think it will be more clear. Now see, compute the consumptive use for the rice. Now the crop is rice for the month of January. Remember, the equation give us the consumptive use on daily basis, but in the question it is required for the a whole month of the January. So when we just get the daily consumptive use, so we will just multiply it by the number of days in the month of January, that is 31. Okay, by using the Penman formula. Okay, so see, now this data is given, that will be the given data which you will have to observe. Okay, that what is the locality, what is the latitude of the area, what is the mean monthly temperature. Okay, so that is the mean monthly temperature for the month of January. Okay, that is the relative humidity, 50%. That is the elevation of the area. Almost elevation is not utilized in the Penman equation, but it's better to you know that its value. Okay, wind velocity at 2 meter height is 25 kilometer per day. Remember, now that is given at 2 meter height, but suppose if it is not given at 2 meter, suppose it is given at 5 meter, at 10 meter, okay, at 7 meter, 8 meter, then you can convert it into 2 meter height. Mean in equation you have to use it at 2 meter height. Clear? Now see, the temperature is 15 degrees C, that is the actual. Now using these values, 20 degree north latitude, 15 degree temperature, 50% of relative humidity, we can take out the rest of the values from the tables. Okay, so see, the actual temperature or the observed temperature is 15 degrees C. Clear? Now from table 3.10, at 15 degrees C, the saturated vapor pressure is 12.79, okay, and the slope at this point is 0.8. So that will be our A value, okay, and this is our saturated vapor pressure. So these two values we have taken out from the tables, saturated vapor pressure and the slope of the plot between the temperature and the saturated vapor pressure. Clear? Now from table 3.11, see the latitude was 20 degrees C, the latitude was 20 degree north, and we were interested to determine the consumptive use for the month of January. Okay, so the mean monthly solar radiation, that is 10.8. clear? Mean 10.8, that is taken out from the table 3.11 at the 20 degree north and in for the month of January. Clear? Similarly, from the table 3.12, see at latitude of 20 degree C, okay, and for the month of January, we will have the the maximum possible hour is 11.1. okay, so that is also taken out from the table, the 11.1. clear? Now the small n, the actual sunshine hour, that is not given in the data, so we can take it from the table 3.9, that is C for the month of January, and at latitude of 20 degree C, that will be taken as 7.74. clear? So so some data was given and some data was taken out from the standardized table. Clear? So that is N. Now see, the saturated vapor pressure is given, okay, and the relative humidity is given, that is 50%. I mean, in the question it is given that the relative humidity is 50%. Now see, the actual vapor pressure will be equal to saturated vapor pressure multiplied by relative humidity. So we have also got the actual vapor pressure. Okay, now we have to find out the drying power of the air. So drying power of the air is a function of the wind velocity at 2 meter height, saturated vapor pressure and actual vapor pressure. So all these three values are given, so just put it here and you will get the 2.59, the drying power of the air. Similarly, now we have to find out the daily solar radiation. Okay, so CRA, mean monthly solar radiation, we have taken it out from the table 10.8. here R, that is the reflection coefficient. Okay, so the given crop is rice. Clear? So we can take it is 0.2. its range is from 0.15 to 0.25. so here we just take it the average value. Clear? Pi is the latitude, so latitude is also given, that is 20 degree to the north. Okay, N is the maximum possible sunshine hour, that is 11.11. Small n, that is the actual sunshine hour, which we have taken as equivalent to P. clear? Sigma, that is the Boltzmann constant, its value is also we know. Okay, TA, that is the actual temperature, so the temperature, observed temperature was 15 degrees C, you have to convert it into Kelvin, so just by adding with it 273, okay, so you will get 288. Here that is not 20, that is 15, so you will get 288 Kelvin. Clear? That is the actual vapor pressure, which we have calculated 6.395. N is again, that is given, this one is also given, so just put all these values, you will get the daily solar radiation. Okay, now see, H is also given, drying power is also given, psychrometric constant, that also we know, we have also taken out the slope of the curve A. So now just put these parameters in the Penman equation and you will get the daily consumptive use, 2.31 millimeter per day. So this much water will be utilized by the rice at a given crop in the given condition, in the given climatic condition. Okay, but in the question it was required to determine the consumptive use for the monthly basis, so just you have to multiply this value by the number of days in the given month. So that is there are 31 days in the month of January, so you just multiply it, you will get the 71.6 millimeter per month. Okay, so that is the actual demand, that is the actual consumptive use, that is the actual water which is evapotranspirated from the rice at a given area. I hope it will be clear to you people. Okay, now third method, the indirect method for the determination of the consumptive use, that is the Hargreaves class A pen evaporation method. Okay, see, class A pen, it has some standard dimension. See the instrument which you are which is given in the slide, that is the that is pen. Okay, that is called pen. Okay, class A pen, it will have some standard dimension like the depth and the surface area. Okay, you just Google it, that what are the standard dimension or recommended dimension for the US class A pen. Clear? So see, remember, if this instrument is not available, then the evaporation from this pen can be calculated by utilizing the meteorological data. And if this equipment is given, then the pen evaporation will be directly observed. Okay, see how it will be observed. You have just to measure the depth of the water in this pen. For example, today at 10 a.m. you have measured the depth of the water. Okay, for example, from the top point to the surface of water. Okay, for example, that is 50 millimeter. Clear? Now tomorrow at 10 a.m. again you measure that that distance. Okay, suppose that is 45 millimeter. 55 millimeter. Mean that will be increased. Okay, that is 55 millimeter. So what is the difference between these two? That is 5 millimeter. So it means that 5 millimeter of water has been evaporated from this class A pen. Clear? Now that is the evaporation from the pen. Now how this 5 millimeter will be converted? Okay, that for example, if there is 5 millimeter evaporation from this pen, how much will be the evaporation from this natural surface? How much will be the evapotranspiration from this crops? So we have to convert the pen evaporation into the crop evapotranspiration. Okay, we have to adjust it. Okay, so see, in this method, just you will have to multiply then the consumptive use coefficient. Okay, mean this EP, either it will be directly observed from the pen if the instrument is given, and if the instrument is not given, then you have to calculate that pen evaporation. Okay, so if the instrument is not given, then calculate it, determine it by this equation. Okay, see, that pen evaporation is equal to 0.459 RA CT CW CH CS CE. See here, one by one, RA, that is the mean monthly solar radiation, which we have already discussed in the previous Pinman equation. Okay, so its values are given. So you will have to know about the latitude of the area. So if you know the latitude of the area and for the given month, so its value will be taken out from the table 3.11. Clear? RA. So RA, that is the mean monthly solar radiation. Okay, that is clear. Now CT, that is the coefficient per temperature. Okay, so coefficient of temperature will be calculated by this equation, but you will have to know the temperature of the area, that is the measured temperature. Okay, the mean temperature of the area. Clear? CW, that is the coefficient for the wind velocity. Okay, but that will be calculated by this equation. So here W is the wind velocity at 0.5 meter height in kilometer per day. Okay, CH, that is the coefficient for the relative humidity. Clear? So you have to measure the humidity, then that humidity will be converted into coefficient of humidity. Clear? CH is also clear. CS, that is the coefficient for the sunshine hour. Okay, so you have to know the S, and the S will be calculated, that is the percentage of bright sunshine hour, and that is equal to 100 N by N. See, again, we have already discussed N is the maximum possible sunshine hour, and this N, that is the actual sunshine hour. So the maximum possible sunshine hour is already given in the recommended table, and this will be either measured or observed, or it will be taken as equivalent to the P, which is we have discussed in the Blaney-Criddle equation. Okay, so N divided by N multiplied by 100, you will get S. Okay, and by putting S in this equation, you will get the coefficient for the sunshine hour. Clear? CE, that is the coefficient for the elevation. Okay, so if you know the elevation of the given area, then you can find out the coefficient of elevation. Okay, so remember, we have two cases. If the class A pen is available, So directly observe the difference between the two heights in the pens, for example in 24 hour, and just multiply it with the crop consumptive coefficient. Or if this equipment is not available with you, so then you will have to practically observe the temperature of the area from which you will get the temperature coefficient. Okay, you will have to observe the wind velocity at 0.5 meter height in kilometer per day, so you will get the coefficient per wind velocity. You will have to observe or measure the humidity, so you will get the coefficient of humidity. You will have to observe the actual sunshine hour. Okay, so then by converting it into S and putting it here, you will get the coefficient of the sunshine hour. And also you will have to know about the elevation of the area. Okay, then you will need these five parameters. So then you will be able to calculate the EP, the pen evaporation. And this pen evaporation will be then converted into the consumptive use of a specific crop by multiplying the consumptive use coefficient. Okay. Now see, what is the consumptive use coefficient? So again, it is a function of the type of crop, it is a function of the location, and most importantly, it is a function of the percentage of the crop growing season, that how much a crop has been matured, how much the crop has been we can say that how much the crop has been cultivated. Okay, yeah, what is the percentage of the growth? Okay, 50% the crop is the 50% of the crop is matured, or 60%, or it is completely matured. So the K is a function of the types of crops, location, and the percentage of growth. But again, either you will have to measure it for the accurate result, but still you can utilize the standard values or recommended values, which is already determined by the different researchers. Clear? So see, the crops are divided into different groups, for example potato, cotton, maize, bean, etc. These are called group A crops. Okay, tomato, oleo, etc., these are called group B crops. Okay, onion, grapes, these are called the group C crops. So we have different groups of the crops. Clear? Rice is considered as paddy, sugarcane, alfalfa, these are called group G crops. Now at the different growth stage, and for these crops the value of K is already given. Okay, for example, if you are interested to determine the consumptive use coefficient per tomato, if it is if its growth is at 20%, yeah, if it is 20%, we can say that matured. Okay, so what will be the consumptive use coefficient? So come here, the growth stage is 20% and the tomato is in group B, so that will be the consumptive use coefficient. Okay, so once you observe the pen evaporation, or once you calculate the pen evaporation, multiply it with the consumptive use coefficient, so you will get the actual water which will be consumed by the given crop at a specific area and at the given climatic condition, for example in 24 hours. Okay, so these were the three basic indirect methods for the determination of the consumptive use. Okay, so remember, these equations are the function of the climatic data or meteorological data. So if the sufficient data is available, if the sufficient meteorological data is available, then the Penman equation will be most recommended. Okay, the lecture will be continued. Thank you.